verse 18. Okay, let's begin from verse 13 because of context. Jesus was in the region of Caesarea Philippi and he asked his disciples, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" And he said, "Some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." Let me tell you, the people did not know who Jesus was. They had A, B, C, D. They had four choices. What was A? John. B, Elijah. C, Jeremiah. And D, one of the prophets. So he asked his disciples, "But who do you say that I am?" And Peter did this exam. I don't know whether it was the level of standard 8 or JSS or university. What did he say? Read. 1, 2, go. Ai mukona baridi hata mwezi kuinua sauti. Nina siwezi kuuliza kama mko kunywa chai because it's likely amjakunywa chai. So, siwezi kuuliza kwani amjakunywa chai. I stopped people from asking those questions because kuna watu wakupata nafasi ya kunywa chai. Sio sawa. Lakini to find some strength to be reading scriptures loudly. Public reading of scripture has a role. It pushes back the powers of darkness. Because the Bible calls the word the sword of the spirit. What did Peter answer and say? The Christ, the Son of the living God. Right. Jesus answered, "Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." So, yo mutiani hapo, Baba Aritik, and it was not part of the four choices of A, B, C, D. Kwa hivyo, kama ulianguka mutiani, si kusema ulianguka. Yako ilikuwa E, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, na haikuwa kwa choices. Kwa hivyo, don't be intimidated at kwa shule au kupita, kwa sababu answers can be outside the question. Amukushika, I think muko na shida nyingi nyinyi hata hata nikiwawekea kajoka mkamati. Lakini sawa, tunawaelewa. Verse 18. I also say to you, everybody read with me, 1, 2, go. I also say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. Praise God. So here the word church is mentioned, and I don't want to go for now, I'll do that later, into the study of the words, church and so forth, but I just want to mention, whatever this church is, it is Jesus' church. Sema amina. Ni church ya nani? He is the one building it. Mwena anajenga nyumba ni Mungu. Sini sawa? Hebrews chapter 3, so that I emphasize whoever is building. Hebrews chapter 3 and verses 3, 4, 5. The Bible says, "For this one, the one there is Christ, has been counted worthy of more glory than Moses, inasmuch as he who builds the house has more honor than what? Than the house." So if the house there is the church, the one building that house is Christ, he has more honor. Jesus has more honor. The next verse says, "For every house is built by someone, but he who builds all things is who? Is God." Are we together? So we thank God that he's a builder of all things. Praise God. So if you go back, Jesus says, "I will build my church." Now the scripture says, my church. That means that church belongs to Christ. The church does not belong to the bishop. The church does not belong to the apostle. The church does not belong to the pastor. The church belongs to who? If you hear a preacher say, "My church," ni kizungu tu inamusumbua. Ni vile kizungu ilikuja na meli, so hakuwa naelewa kizungu sana. So akajaribu kusema kanisa langu, lakini sio lake. The church belongs to who? Christ. So by the way, if you are not happy with Christ, you are not happy with the bride of Christ. You are not happy with muke wa wenyewe. Wachana na muke wa wenyewe. Mana Kristo die Bwana na kanisa ndilo nini? Bi ama muke. Are we together? The other day, some elders in Mount Kenya were challenging another pastor. Asema we uliacha mila, sijui nini, uliacha nini, sijui nini. Wakamsumbua sana. Naye akapata revelation. How many of you know you can get a revelation from the Father? Unajua aliwajibu aje? Akawauliza, kwa hiyo hiyo kacha yenu huko hiyo mlima, msichana akiolewa aende kwa mume, huwa anafuata desturi yao mahali alitoka ama mahali ameolewa? Mnajua nyinyi, si ni mahali umeolewa? Are we together? So Joseph, kama huyu ulimwoa kutoka Msambweni akuje kwenu, si sasa ataacha hiyo, si ndio Pastor Eunice? Si utaacha hiyo desturi ya kwenu Msambweni, unakaa kama watu wa huko, alafu utakuja kufanya nini? Kufuata hii kacha ya mahali umeolewa, si ndio? So huyu pastor akamwambia wazee, mimi niliolewa na Jesus, ama bride of Christ. So niliacha kacha ya kwetu, nikaenda kacha ya kina nani? Simpigie makofi mahali popote alipo. Unafuata kacha ya mahali umeolewa. Amen. Aya. So the church first and foremost is not our idea. It's the church of God. Praise God. It belongs to Christ. Now, church, because church, most people think church is a building, but church is the people of God. There are many definitions, but simply people of God. Say people of God. Sema watu wa Mungu. Are we together? So the church is people of God more than anything else. Now, the church is the new covenant people of God, and it is rooted in the promises of Israel. For us to understand church, we have to go into the promises that God gave to Israel. And then the church was inaugurated, started, brought into being by the Holy Spirit. So Rom Takatifu ali inaugurate the church. And this church refers to all believers who are the people of God, all those who believe in Jesus Christ. So anytime you think about the church, it is those who believe, not on anything. It is those who believe in Jesus Christ, both those who are dead and they believed, they are part of the church because they are in heaven, and those who are alive who believe, they believe in Christ, they are part of the church, including all local gatherings of those believers of Jesus Christ. That is the church. Glory to God. And many people in history, the church of Jesus in history, theologians and fathers and leaders over the years have tried to always make definition in their conferences. When I attended in the 90s and early 20s global conferences on evangelism, they were always defining evangelism in, because without a proper definition, then you cannot understand. And so even the word church has come under major definitions over the years, and I want to just take 2-3 minutes and go into a serious study. Glory to God. The historic perspectives of the church. Now, this one I'm just preaching to Gigi for the next 3 minutes, because he and anafanya Gigi report, yanasoma vitu kama hizi, na ako karibu ku graduate this year with his PhD. Congratulations. Uko JKUAT. Asante sana. Sasa wao kigaiwa hiyo degree, unanikumbuka sababu ni brother yako. Sasa unajua John Calvin, si ndio? Unajua John Calvin? Good. Right. So John Calvin alikuwa nani? Mtumishi wa Bwana in the Reformation. Kulikuwa na akina Martin Luther na wengine waliandika sana, akina Calvin na wakuja pia. This is what he says about the church. Wherever we see the word of God fully, wherever we see the word of God purely preached and heard. The word of God purely preached and heard. And the sacraments administered according to Christ's institution. There, it is not to be doubted, a church of God exists. Where? That place. Where what? The word of God is purely preached. The word of God is heard. And the sacraments administered according to Christ's institution. Now, I know there is a technical word called sacraments. Lakini wale mlikuwa Catholic, munaelewa sacrament. Ama muelewi sacramenti? Okay. Kuna watu waelewi sacramenti, mana ni jenisi mbulikuja Jews mkazaliwa kwa Pentecostal. What is a sacrament? Kuna mtu wapa likuwa Catholic, tuambia sacrament nini? Mtusaidia watu wa Mungu. Tuambia waka sacrament nini? Sio ile kamukate, okay. Sawa. So, the Lord's table, the bread and the wine, the Holy Communion is a sacrament. Okay, is an act. Water baptism is one of those kind of things. Are we together? But as we don't look at it that way, we're just saying there are certain biblical doctrinal practices that are done only purely by the church. Ushawe kuona serikali kifanya communion. Ati ministers wako mahali retreat Naivasha. Wanainua kamkate nasema, Jesus said, as often as we meet. No. Hiyo inafanya tu by the believers of the Lord Jesus Christ. And let me tell you something about the church. The church is the most powerful institution in the world and in history. Let me also add, the church is the largest institution of people in the world that has ever been. It's bigger than political parties. It's bigger than governments in any place in the world. The church includes those who died in Christ and those who are alive in Christ. They are more than anything you can imagine. And it was out of the promise that God gave to Abraham. The church is part of what God promised Abraham. Look at Genesis 15 and verse 5. Look at this promise. God brought, read verse 4 in context. Because Abraham was asking about his heir. He said, behold, the word of the Lord came to me saying, they shall not be your heir, who Eliezer, but he who will come from your own body shall be your heir. Then God took him outside. He said, look now toward heaven and count the stars if you are able to number them. And he said to him, so shall your descendants be, my God. The church is like the stars of the heavens you can't number. Millions and billions of people that have died in Jesus in the last 2,000 years, they are still part of the crowd of witnesses. They are part of the church. In fact, when Isaac came, when Abraham laid Isaac on the altar in Genesis 22, and God was pleased with that act, he made a promise to Abraham one more time in verse 17 of Genesis 22. He said, in blessing, I'll bless you, and in multiplying, I will multiply your descendants as the stars of heaven and as the sand which is on the seashore. Let me tell you, the church is the greatest, largest, most powerful body of people in the world. That is what has ever been. And let me tell you, the church continues to be the largest and the greatest on the earth under the commander, the captain of our salvation, the Lord Jesus Christ. And himself, he said, I'm building it. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Let me tell you something. The last 2,000 years, the church has faced so much trouble. Fires, tyrant governments, emperors that are persecuted, burnt preachers, and, you know, killed many with a sword over the years. And some survived, some did not. But let me tell you something. 2,000 and more after, we still have the church worshiping God in every part of the earth today. Tell your neighbor, relax. The church belongs to Christ. There was a definition that came up for church in 1530. 1530. 1530, those are almost 500 years before. The Lutherans those days, they came up with what was called Ashbach Confession of 1530. This is what they said about the church. The church is a congregation of saints, and then they put in bracket, the assembly of all believers, the saints, in bracket, the assembly of all believers, in which the gospel is rightly taught, in bracket, purely preached, and the sacraments rightly administered, in bracket, according to the gospel. So, key words. The church is a congregation of the saints. These are the assembly of believers, in which the gospel is rightly taught, where it's purely preached, and the sacraments rightly administered according to the gospel. Najua masomo mlikataa, amtaki mambo masomo, ndio tukiwasomea ma statement ngumu ngumu. Unasema pana wewe man of God, rudi uchome. Ngoja tutachoma baadaye, lakini kwa sababu we are laying foundation, acha tusome kidogo ile masomo liachana after certificate, diploma, degree, masters and so forth. Watuweza kusoma. Kuna kitu kingine naitwa the Belgian Confession of Faith. Now, I'm quoting a professor who is called Christopher Morgan, professor of theology and dean of School of Christian Ministries at California Baptist University in Riverside. So, ukisikia professor wa theology, hii mambo imeleta shida sana over the years. Baka kuamua, we are going to research and dig in and find out what is the church. Kwa sababu leo, karibu nyinyi vijana mnashindwa kujua kanisa ni nini. Kwa hivyo hii swali na hii shida imekuweko miaka mingi. So we are in 1530. How old are you? Listen to what I say. Your 1530, tumemaliza your 1530. Walisema hivi in the Belgian Confession of Faith. Says, the marks by which the true church is known are these. Is what they said. The marks by which the true church is known are these. If the pure doctrine of the gospel is preached therein. Somebody say, pure doctrine of the gospel is preached. So where that is done, that's a good mark. Secondly, if she maintains the pure administration of the sacraments as instituted by Christ. In other words, if they maintain the pure administration of the sacraments as instituted by Christ. Thirdly, if church discipline is exercised in punishing sin. If church discipline is exercised in punishing sin. In short, if all things are managed according to the pure word of God, all things contrary thereto rejected. In other words, kama kuna vitu contrary to the word of God, they are also rejected. So in that church, in that place, if church church discipline is exercised, sin is punished, and things are managed according to the pure word of God, and all things contrary are rejected. In other words, church should be courageous enough to reject certain things. So if that is going on, and Jesus Christ is acknowledged as the head of the church, that's another mark. That Jesus Christ is acknowledged as what? As the head of the church. Oh my God, this confession said, hereby the true church may certainly be known, from which no man has a right to separate himself. If those marks are in place, then the true church can now be known, and from which no man should separate himself from such church. In 1784, Bado Mungu na mimi, 17 what? Those early churches, we've heard what the Lutherans said. The Methodists themselves came up with something called Methodist Articles of Religion, 1784. They said something about church. This is what they say. The visible church of Christ is a congregation of faithful men. A congregation of what? Faithful men. In which the pure word of God is preached. So, in that congregation of men, what happens? The pure word of God is preached. And the sacraments duly administered. In one kind of those early days, the word sacrament was very major. The sacraments were duly administered according to Christ's ordinance. In all those things that of necessity are requisite to the same. Apo aliongea kama learned friends. In other words, anasema hizo vitu zote zimefanywa pamoja. The faithful men have congregated, the pure word of God is being preached, and the sacraments are being administered according to Christ's ordinance. That is the church. Are we together? Niendele na hizo kudig definitions ama tuachane. Wachani endele kwa sababu mimi niko na kameme, and there's nothing you can do about it. Now, in 1861, when the Swedish Baptist Confession of Faith, this is what they say. Unajua, Reformation took place in Europe in 1500 with Martin Luther. So Lutherans came out, all these other Protestants, they came up, and they kept having the challenge to say, what is the church? Because they kept trying to solve the problems of their day. So we are not the first people to come to a time when church is kind of losing relevance, definition, meaning. So we have to teach this generation what is the church. And let you know, we are not the only people that have faced this problem. Others in 1861. Is what they said. We believe that our true Christian church is a union of believing and baptized Christians. Comma. Is a union of who? Believing and baptized Christians who have covenanted to strive to keep all that Christ has commanded. So they have covenanted to strive to keep, endeavor to keep all that Christ has commanded, to sustain public worship, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, Listen, to choose among themselves shepherds or overseers and deacons. Now, I want you to notice that from 1530, now we are in 1861, the definition of the church has continued to reveal certain other dimensions in the scriptures. Initially, it was purely gathering all believers in Jesus Christ. Are we together? The gospel is being preached and must be pure gospel, and the sacraments are being administered. Now, here, it has now continued to expand that these guys are committed to keep all that Christ commanded. Then they have to sustain public worship under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Now, Roho ameletwa hapo. The Holy Spirit is guiding that institution. So, if the Holy Spirit is guiding that institution, unless wewe uwe mkubwa kuliko Roho. Useme sasa Roho kaa kando, wacha sasa niongoze. Guidance of the Holy Spirit. And they are guided to do what? To choose among themselves shepherds or overseers and deacons. And what is the work of these guys? To administer baptism and the Lord's Supper. That's communion, baptism and the Lord's Supper. Now you can see what we were calling sacraments before. You see now what are sacraments? Administering baptism, the Lord's Supper. Listen, it goes further to say to practice Christian church discipline. Now, church discipline is something that people have ignored, but it's part of the marks of a church to administer and practice Christian church discipline to promote godliness and brotherly love. Ah, the church now is going further to say, because we gathered and we believe in Jesus and we came together in public worship, but there are certain other dimensions. We have brought the leadership of the Holy Spirit. Now we have leaders, shepherds, overseers, and deacons. We are now administering baptism and the Lord's Supper. We are practicing church discipline. We are promoting godliness and brotherly love, and to contribute, listen, to the general spread of the gospel. So the church is also contributing to the general spread of the gospel, also that every such church is an independent body, free in its relation to other Christian churches, and acknowledging Christ as its head. In other words, in every age and time, the headship of Jesus over the church has never been questioned. Jesus Christ is still the head of the church. So I'm asking you the question. Are you part of the church of Jesus Christ? If you are part of the church of Jesus Christ, there are a few elements from all those definitions that you must agree with and hold dearly. Number one, that you believe in Jesus Christ. You not only believe, you have accepted him as personal Lord and Savior. Number two, you have been baptized in water as a requirement for all believers. Number three, you are available for fellowship and breaking bread and doing Holy Communion together with faithful men. Glory to God. Number four, that you have chosen to be part of that place where the gospel is being preached purely without compromise. And I believe Life Church is one of those places. Here we don't compromise the word. We are radical for Jesus. When we started this church the year 2000, we said we are discipling radical converts. That's where the RR type came from. Radical remnant. Because this is not 1861. This is 2024. Definition is expanding as the scriptures are becoming clearer. So you believe in Christ, glory to God. You have been baptized in water, hallelujah, amen. You are available for the Lord's Supper, praise God. And then you have identified that place, the pure gospel of the word is preached, praise God. You have come under shepherds or pastors, overseers, and deacons. In other words, you have accepted the leadership that has been set there by the Holy Spirit. Are you listening to me? And then you are ready to express your brotherly love to
together with the other believers. Oh my God. And that every time, therefore, there is a gathering, you are ready for worship. And then finally, you are ready for the spread of the gospel of Jesus Christ in that community. And Jesus remains the head of that church. That is a real explanation, definition, declaration of what the church of Christ is. Are we together? Now, the church in real definition, let me take you to a scripture which is interesting. Two scriptures. To answer now, Jude. Commentator says this was a brother of Jesus. Jesus had brothers and sisters. Have you ever considered that when Jesus was born later, Joseph and Mary had other children? Can you imagine sisters of Jesus? Can you imagine somebody marrying who? My wife is sister of Jesus. So Jesus is my brother in love. Hey, those people are privileged. I hope they believed in their brother-in-law. God saved, and now that they are in heaven, to kinda heaven to introduce you. You know, be there forever. There'll be times for introductions. That is Noah. Hey, Noah. And now kweli lijenga. Na mafundi ya waku ingia ark. Uyo ni Jonah. Hey, how was it? Dani ya samaki 3 days, Jonah. Wow. Sarah, how did you feel when your only son was taken on the altar? You say, I left the man. You know, Sarah left Abraham. You know, I think that'll be very powerful. So that day we'll have introduction of Jesus, you know, mother, okay, Mary, Joseph, and the other brothers. Are we together? I think it'll be fun. Ask your neighbor, do you want to be there in that meeting in heaven? If you abandon the church and Christ and castigate the Lord who shed his blood on the cross, you're likely to miss heaven. But that will not happen as long as we are here. We will teach you, we'll encourage you, we'll show you the way, we'll pray for you, we'll ensure. Even when you sin, we will discipline you. We may even send you out of church temporarily. 2 years, usikuja hapa, mwenye dhambi umekataa kabisa kusikia sisi, lakini tutakutembelea private tulize. Hujakubali kutubu. Because the church also should discipline. Najua hapo mpendi sana because you think utashikwa. But I believe you are holy saints. Let's hear what Jude said in chapter 1 verse 1. Jude, a bond servant of Jesus Christ. Bond servant is slave of Jesus Christ. Hey, being a slave of your brother. But of course we don't know each other in the flesh. We are talking about spiritual language. And brother of James, to those, he's writing to who? To those who are called, sanctified by God the Father and preserved in Jesus Christ. Wow. I like the definition of those in the church. Number one is those who are called. Number two, they are sanctified. They are those who are sanctified, made set apart. They are sacred. They are consecrated. And they are preserved in Jesus Christ. Somebody say, we are preserved. So may that preservation, by the way, continue in your life in the name of Jesus. Naomba akuna mosquito, akuna pepo, akuna muchawi, akuna shaitani, ata toa wewe, ata ondoa wewe, kutoka kwa uhusiano wako na Kristo. The Bible says, nothing shall separate us from the love of God. Can I hear an amen in the house of God? Look at the prayer of Paul because of this matter in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 23. This is what the Bible says. Now may the God of peace himself, what will he do? Sanctify you how? Completely. And may your whole spirit, soul and body be preserved how? Blameless at the coming of our Jesus Christ. In other words, siku ile anakuja utakuwa umehifadhiwa sawa sawa, and God himself is taking charge of his church. Zaroshataya. Amen. So the go back to Jude 1. We're going to read that verse in the Amplified Version. Hey, imekuwa kubwa. Sawa, rudisha kwa Amplified. Hawa watu acha wao inaanza kuona. Amplified Version. Jude, a bond servant of Jesus Christ and the brother of James, writes this letter to those who are the called. Who are the called there? God's chosen ones. The elect. My God, that's who you are. Tell your neighbor you are chosen. Kama huna jina mtoto, muite chosen. Mama chosen. Baba who? Chosen. Glory to God. Ata kuita mtoto muti. Muringa, mama muringa. You know, tafuta majina kama hisi. Praise God. You know, Africans in some regions called their children names of animals, and the idea was to ward off demons from their children. That's why they called their children names of animals. So nasita ingilia kati. Just say God's chosen ones, the elect, dearly loved by God the Father, and kept secure and set apart for Jesus Christ. Those are the members of the church of Jesus Christ. These are the ones. Oh yes, chosen ones. They are loved. Praise God. They are secured. They are set apart for Jesus Christ. Now, the church is defined also as an assembly. The actual word, assembly. I will build my church. Assembly. And you have assembly in places. Let's go to Corinth, for instance, and see the assembly in Corinth. Chapter 1 of 1 Corinthians, verse 1 and verse 2. Paul first introduces himself. He says, called to be an apostle of Jesus Christ through the will of God. That means he is God's chosen, elected. This time he's elected and chosen and placed as in the office of an apostle. Are we together? Okay, here is writing, and Sosthenes, our brother. So when Paul was writing this letter, he had an assistant, somebody helping him. Anaitwa nani? Hiyo jina ni ngumu, mimi siwezi kuita mtoto wangu wapi? Sosthenes, because watakata, watu Nairobi watakata, tasema baba Sos. Shwale, watu wengine hata mwezi kusimile na vile najaribu. Na kuna baridi, najaribu kuwahubiria tu na moyo mkunjuvu, moyo umejitolea. Nairobi kubaya, utsipo smile tafadhali. Smile watu wa Mungu. Are we together? Tell your neighbor they want to see your teeth. Usikasirike ni kama kila kitu imeharibika. Hapana. Bado tuna breathe the hewa ya God. Are we together? Bado anatusaidi? Eh. Sijui sasa kuna jamaa ati amesmoke nini? Tear gas. Na ilikuwa tu fake. Hakuna kusmoke tear gas. Ilikuwa tu kunini zayada. Unajua propaganda pia ni mzuri. Lakini kama alismoke, we congratulate him. Tusome verse 2. To the church of God, which is where? So may this also be said to the church of God, which is at Kenya Cinema. Let's say the church of God, which is at Nairobi. It's better Nairobi because Nairobi was a metropolitan city. Let's cut it down. To those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus. So in Corinth, there are those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus. They are set apart. These ones are peculiar people. These are special treasure. These are royal priesthood according to Peter. These are sanctified in Christ Jesus in that Corinth. Let's go a little deeper. No, a little further. Called to be saints. Now, first of all, notice Saints are not those who are dead. I know because of where you came from, Saint Agatha. So saints, often in some church circles, is those who are dead. But here Paul was not writing to dead people. He's writing to breathing brothers and sisters. Who are where? In Corinth. Are we together? Saints. I know pale kwenu village, hapo, 2 kilometers pande ya chini, kuna Saint Peter. Sindio? So, ama Saint Thomas. Kwa hivyo, ujue sasa, hata wewe ni saint, if you are set apart, sanctified in Christ Jesus. Look at the saint next to you and don't say anything. Iki tu kusema, ho, no, I'm not an angel, I'm not a saint. No, the Bible calls you saint. Kayado. The Bible says what the blood of Jesus did for you was powerful, was real. You are washed truly. Your sins were thrown as far as east, as far from west. Believe it and accept it. You are a saint. Tell the devil he is a liar. Somebody shout, I'm a saint.
Do you believe it?
Stone throwing saint. Sawa. But you are a saint. Najua mimi ni mchokozi, lakini hata hivyo sijawachokoza sana. Si unajua wewe ukijoin Life Church ukuja hapa, siwezi kuwahubiria tu kama reverend tu hivi tu ukiboeka. Hapana. Lazima niwe na nini? Because everybody is different and I am different. Ama namna gani? So God to be saint. Why I like this verse, Pastor Gigi and my friend, is because don't honor the saints in one place. It says, with all who in every place call on the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, both theirs and ours. I like these saints. They are everywhere. They are everywhere. The saints are everywhere. That's why I said the Church of Jesus Christ is the greatest organization, body of believers, not organization, but the greatest body of believers, a community of people than any other organization in the world. That's why every government fears the church. Every group does not know what to do with the church, especially in America, because of their development, modernism, science, technology, openness, freedom. They don't know what to do with this mysterious group of people called the saints of the Most High, called the Church of Jesus. They have tried everything they can to silence them and mute them. You mute them, they come back. Oh yes, you shut that prayer meeting, you hear them praying in another place. The gospel is bearing fruit everywhere. Naona hapo mungeni support, lakini mungataa kunisupport. Vile nimetolea hiyo point, wacha mimi ni support na scripture. Colossians 1 verse 6. The Bible says, na munaandika hizi scriptures ama ni mimi nazitupa tu kwa hewa zibaki hivyo? Okay, tusome, which rudi mahali kuna sentence full stop inaanza. Because rudi hapo. Paul says what? We give thanks to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you. I was in Colossae. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of your love for the saints, for all the saints. Did you hear all the saints? Because the saints are everywhere, many. I thank God for the church. Now, because of the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, I thank God. The saints, by the way, we have hope which is laid up for us in heaven, of which you heard before in the word of truth, of the truth and of the gospel. Now, how did one become a saint? He heard the gospel. He heard the truth. Praise God. You heard before what? The word of truth. You also heard what? The gospel. What's the gospel? Good news about somebody. What is his name? Jesus Christ. So you Colossians, you heard the word of truth. Remember, in the church, the gospel, it is where the gospel is preached in its purest form. Hakuna corruption, hakuna compromise. It's the word of truth, praise God, where the gospel is preached, hallelujah, that Jesus is Lord, that Jesus is the head of the church, that Jesus is the head of all principality and power, that Jesus is the firstborn, the first fruits from the dead. Nobody ever died and rose again and is due a life. Oh my God. The truth of the word of the gospel. Listen. Now, you have heard before. You have heard. Look at the next verse. That's where we are reading all that. Which has come to you. That means the word of the gospel has come to you, as it has also in all the world. Yeah, the gospel is not just coming here. It's also going all the world. And it's bringing forth fruit. Oh, hallelujah. Wherever this gospel is being preached, it is bringing forth fruit. Hallelujah. As it is also among you since the day you heard. Yes, it's also bearing fruit among us since we heard and knew the grace of God in truth. The point is, wherever the gospel of Jesus Christ is being preached, it is bearing fruit. Oh, yes. Next month, we are sending a team. Gigi, we are sending Pastor Gigi to Philippines. He's going to Philippines. Where else are you going? He's also going to Nepal. Only those two places. But you will pass through Malaysia. So Asia is going to hear the gospel. So wherever the gospel, this man will preach, that gospel of Jesus is going to bear fruit. Like it's doing all over the world. Praise God. Right. And me, I will also go to preach in another nation, the same time, in another place. And wherever I preach, the gospel will bear fruit. People will be saved. People will be healed. They'll be baptized with the Holy Spirit, with evidence of speaking in tongues. We will preach with the signs and wonders and miracles following as a full proof that Jesus Christ is still alive. Hey. I like him. Nani mwingine anataka kwenda mahali tumutume? Tukutume wapi? Wacha tukutume hapa Kibera kwanza. Hapa tu, sio mbali. Praise God. Ama Huruma. Ama Karen. Karen is better. We can send you to Karen. Praise God. So, somebody say, the saints are everywhere. Everywhere where? In the world. Are we together? Let me, because this matter is so big and we can't finish, I want to say, there's a lot of evidence in scripture of multiple gatherings of the saints in a city in different places. And let me give you a few references, like five of them. One, all in 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 4. Let's begin there. Look at what the Bible says. 1 Corinthians 5, verse 4. Paul is saying something very powerful. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, when you are gathered together, along with my spirit, with the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now listen, let me dissect that for you. Every time, according to our definitions, the church gathers the leaders, they have leaders in their midst. And number two, the Spirit of God is there. And the heart, spirit of the leadership is there. And the power of our Lord Jesus Christ is there. This morning, we are assembled here in this house. We are gathered. We are gathered. Hello? Let's assume, siku hapa leo, niwe nilikuwa na ubiri kama wapi, nipee muji. Kakamega. Ah, nimepewa Kakamega. Garissa, achana nayo. Nimepewa Kakamega. So, If this morning I was preaching Kakamega, Pastor Sam, I know you watch, we greet you. Atakama nikoje, my spirit will be assembled with you here. My heart is here. In fact, hata nikuwa nikiangalia online kidogo. Atakama tukua ibada huko, tunenua mukono, nafunga jicho moja, nangona face munaona, bado muko. Because my spirit is gathered with you. That's what Paul is saying. Siko na nyinyi lakini, when you are gathered together, along with my spirit, with the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, I know that could be a doctrinal matter, gathered with spirit, but I can try to bring another verse to try to solve that mystery. Go to, now ukienda urudi, all right? Hebrews chapter 12, verse 25, we begin to hear about this church. Let's go back to actually 18. Let's go back to 18. For you have not come to the mountain that may be touched and burnt with fire, and to blackness and darkness and tempest. Now, here is a comparison of what happened in Mount Zion when the Israelites gathered that mountain. You could not touch it. God was living in the mountains. You don't come near. There was burning of fire and all these problems. The next verse. And a sound of trumpet. In that mountain there was sound of trumpet, voice of words, so that those who heard it begged that the word of God should not be spoken to them anymore. Hata waliambia Musa, wewe usi, Mungu asikuje, wewe wakwambie, utuletee information. Unakumbuka if you have read Old Testament? So the writer of Hebrews is saying, we have not come to that kind of mountain ya kuogopeshwa hivyo. For they could not endure which was commanded, as if as much as a beast touches the mountain, it shall be stoned and shot with an arrow. You could not play around with the where the presence of God was, that mountain. And so terrifying was the sight that Moses said, I'm exceedingly afraid and trembling. But we have come. So the verse before is saying, we have not come to that kind of Old Testament kind of mountain. Are we together? We are not assembled in that kind of place. But now here is saying, but we have come. So this is the New Testament coming. We have come where? Not Mount Sinai, this time Mount Zion, to the city of the living God. Look at these descriptions. The heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels. So when we gather right now here on Mount Zion, it's called the city of the living God. We have gathered to a place which is also called like heavenly Jerusalem. We have come to a place where there are angels. That's why sometimes we sing about angels. We are standing on a holy ground. Hallelujah. And there are angels all around. Angels, we wave at you wherever you are. Now, verse 23 says, we have come to what? To the general assembly. Now, the and church of the firstborn who are registered in heaven. Do you see how people join church? First, you are born again, believe in Jesus, you are baptized, you are registered in heaven before you are registered on in the church here in a local place. Are we together? So we have come to God, the judge of all. And look at something else in that gathering. To the spirits of just men made perfect. So let's go back to the Corinthians, because now you can see spirits of holy men, just men that have been made mature, made perfect. The church. Look, that's why we talk of Abraham. Are you kuapa? We talk of David today. Are you kuapa? We're talking of Moses. Are you kuapa? This Elijah. Are you kuapa? Or maybe we talk about those who are not buried. Moses, Enoch, and who else? Elijah alizikwa ama akuzikwa? Akuzikwa. Pole, but siku moja, the Ethiopian Airlines ilianguka na watu wakapotea. Do you remember? Na sisi tukaadhirika. We are two people who are connected with us. So one time, I sent an elder to go to a family to encourage them because walikuwa wamepoteza mwenzao. So and it was very, very painful and grieving. So natafuta scripture. And after, then I got memory of scripture. Nikambia huyu elder, fanya hivi, go and tell them There were also three people who were never buried. And you read those scriptures. Enoch, Moses, Elijah, and their relative. And they were comforted. And nikwambia usiseme, umeambiwa na apostle, sema Mungu amekuonekania, akakupea your information through the Holy Spirit, who is also through the man of God. But don't mention, just minister to them. So when you are assembled in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and my spirit is present with the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. You're in 1 Corinthians 5, 4. Number two is 1 Corinthians 11, verse 18. We are showing how the church, you can identify church assembly. First of all, when you come together as a church, I hear that there are divisions among you, and in part, I believe it. Paul alikuwa kitu ingine. Yeye alikuwa anapata information hata akiwa mbali, because his spirit he was also always with them. I mean, is a saying to say he is part of the fellowship and he can get information. But the point here in this verse is when you come together as a church. Tell your neighbor, congratulations for coming together today. So, everyone who believes in Jesus must identify a place where you must come together with other saints. Not once in a while, I attend any church in any city where I find myself. You are not a vagabond always to be on the streets. You need to belong. Are we together? Another verse 3. The same chapter 11, verse 33. The Bible says, therefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, wait for one another. This is instructions for Holy Communion. When you are coming together to eat the Lord's Supper, si ukipewa, unakula. Ukipewa, unakula. Ukipewa, wait. Baka ule mungina pewe, and then you can eat together. Leo nimeambia story yote. Bado? Makosa kubwa. Story number one, ili tumalize ibada. Zile siku, nilikuwa na ubiri tu hapa na pale, na sana sana pale. They used to call me Evangelist David Juma in the mid-80s, late 80s, 90s. So, then late 90s, nikaanza kusikia the Lord say we didn't need to do church planting. And all the 90s, tuliubiri tukisema, no, we don't plant churches as we preach here and there, and especially there, you know. So now the Lord began to speak to me that we need to preserve and conserve the harvest. So, na nilikuwa naona ni ngumu. Maana unafikiria ni kazi rahisi kuongoza kanisa? Nasema, siku hizi kanisa ni biashara, kanisa ni pesa, hawa watu wanajimudu. I wish naweza kununulia Bible mpya. Na nikuambia, chukua Bible, anza kanisa. Within 3 months, utanirudishia Bible na uhame Kenya. If you are not called, wachana nao. So, hata sisi, tulikuwa tunaogopa. Nasema, pana, wachana nao. Lord, leave me. I stayed for 6 months refusing. Then one day, I had a dream. Hii ilikuwa kali. This is what the Lord showed me. Ati niko kwa church, uko village, kaholo kamejaa. Now they are doing Holy Communion. So nimeka hapo, kwa line ya mbele mahali, vile ilikuwa naka, tunakula Holy Communion. So I observed, nikaona, hawa watu, wani unakula communion aje? Mtu akipewa, anakula na meza. Mwingine akipewa, so pande hii washa kula, wakamaliza, pande hii bado wanangojea. So nikaona kuna confusion. Nikaona hawa watu hawajui kufanya nini? Meza bwana. Hawa watu hawajui. So nikaanza kusikia kohea hea. Inaitwaje in English? Kusikia passion and fire. Kwa feeling anticipation. I'm waiting. So then in my spirit nikasikia, I'm waiting. They give me the mic so that I show them how to take Holy Communion in an orderly way. And when they do that, then the glory of God will hit this place. Then as soon as now that came, then a verse came in my spirit, which is this same chapter, verse 23. This is what it says. It says, for I received from the Lord that which I also deliver to you. So I knew in the spirit there is something I have received from the Lord that I need to deliver to these people. Then I woke up. So you prophets, dream interpreters, interpret that for me. What was the Lord telling me? Umeshindwa. That is kumoja, nitakuwa kanisani, kazi yangu itakuwa kuonyesha watu order, na hiyo ni kazi ya mitume. Order, orderly way, arrange things properly, orderly, leaders nyika ni hapa, ukate, deacons kani hapo, nini, orderly, orderly. And if we do things orderly, according to what I have received from the Lord, then I deliver to you. Kwanza he spoke to me in the old King James. You know, hii ni ya kuhubiri. Kuna hile tunasikiaga nayo, hile original. Inasema, for I received of the Lord that which I also delivered unto you. So when I woke up from there, I knew, Lord, nimekubali, umenionyesha kabisa, imambo ya church umeniitia, na hii nitafanya. Si Joseph hata wewe utembelewe usiku ama mchana, waambiwe tu vile the next 15 years is gonna be, you know, in ministry. Because we are human beings and we sometimes come under pressure and we really don't want to do things out of touch. We need guidance from the Lord. And I declare in this service, the same God who spoke to me, may he also speak to you concerning the case and the matter you're struggling with and asking. I declare right now in the name of Jesus, get direction, get insight, get revelation, get a download. Maswali ulionayo na ujibiwe kwa jina la Yesu. Mana uwepo wake, ukiwepo mahali, hautakwama, hautakwama. Kwama milele, lazima utapata suruhisho karika jina la Yesu Kristo. Natangaza suruhisho karika kanisa hili. Hivile Bwana aliniongelesha, aka sort out my questions. Hivyo hivyo, na Bwana akujibu. Maana anajibu, anaonyesha njia. Unatafuta suruhisho kazini, pata majibu. Unatafuta suruhisho karika kazi zako, pata direction in the name of Jesus. Whatever is your question, the Holy Ghost knows how to communicate and give you instructions in the mighty name of Jesus. And whatever the Lord tells you, do it, do it. Fill the six water pots with water at that wedding of Cana of Galilee. Fill the water pots with water. Whatever Jesus tells you to do, do it. Karosha Dayaba.